It's been 1 year since a devastating earthquake leveled parts of Haiti, killing almost a quarter of a million people. And today, with only a fraction of that rubble removed, the grief of that day is still raw. Today, the bustling streets of Port-au-Prince grew quiet as people in the capital marked the anniversary of the worst natural disaster in that country's history. Yeah,
it's estimated more than 230,000 people were killed in the quake, with many survivors now threatened by a cholera epidemic. 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer traveled to Haiti last year in the aftermath of the quake. He joins us live from Southeast Baltimore tonight to reflect on that disaster. Lowell?
Yeah, Stan and Donna, it was a year ago, 5 days from now, when we boarded USNS Comfort behind me here and with its crew headed on down to Haiti for a very emotional and action-packed trip. The ship was pushed to its limits. It was the largest effort ever put forth by USNS Comfort. And now, just a year later, unfortunately, there is still a lot of work to be done in that country. USNS Comfort left the port of Baltimore on January 16, 2010, and arrived in Port-au-Prince, Haiti at around midnight January 20th, when the first of the critically injured were brought on board. Chief Eric Davenport, who is in charge of nursing services on the massive hospital ship, remembers it well.
That was the time that we took Comfort to its capacity, and it was the biggest thing we've done.
The crew of almost 1,000 treated patients day and night around the clock, almost 900 in fact, before heading back to Baltimore on March 10th.
Being able to be a part of probably one of the largest military humanitarian assistance programs was incredible.
As Chief Davenport reflects back on the mission a year later, other humanitarian groups and medical staff from the Baltimore area are as well.
I think what we've seen now over the last year is tremendous resilience of the Haitian people and them starting to build back, and we're hoping, working together, to build back better.
Sean Callahan, Executive Vice President of Overseas Operations for Catholic Relief Services, says despite reports that 5 to 10% of Haiti has been repaired, a lot of ground is being covered. 11 News was on the scene at St. Froid de Sales Hospital, where more than 60 were killed when that hospital actually collapsed on top of itself. Catholic Relief Services was there as well, and Callahan says they are almost done with rebuilding it.
We've actually relocated the hospital at this time and set up a temporary hospital so we could continue to service the clientele that was being served there. And we're now in the process of finalizing rubble removal and developing a plan for its reconstruction.
Members of the University of Maryland medical staff were also there, like registered nurse Laura Cabahug.
The thing to remember about the earthquake in terms of Port-au-Prince was that it was almost like a complete destruction of everything, of buildings, of any type of infrastructure. You know, be it political, be it social, be it healthcare-wise, like it was massive.
The 7.0 magnitude earthquake killed more than 200,000 people in Haiti, and there are still many challenges a year later, including a cholera outbreak and political unrest. And while the people of Haiti remain positive, at least as much as they can, time will only tell if the country can come back.
I think what really stands in the way is the same thing that stands in the way for every country, particularly a country that is very challenged in their resources, is just having the capacity to do it.
The Catholic Relief Services and the University of Maryland Medical System continue to help to this day in Haiti. As far as the Comfort is concerned, it has a planned humanitarian mission in April. The last stop will be in Haiti, and many crew members are hoping to meet up with those that they helped just a year ago. In Canton, I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, Lowell, thank you.